Oh. I am at my college.
Let me show you. I'm at my college.
So I'm here with my youngest baby girl. She has a college tour today. And we're just checking out different colleges. She applied for some schools in Jersey and Manhattan. And I really, really, really want her to come to my college. For the simple fact is I just think that coming out of high school, you need a lot of support. You need a lot of mommy support. And I don't know, transitioning from high school to college is, it can be very stressful and very confusing. And you don't want to develop like anxiety or, you know, stuff like that, or depression or stuff like that. So I just think that she needs to stay home, at least until she does her first 2 years. But at the end of the day, the decision is all hers. So she wants to have her own record label someday and to run her own business. And she's thinking that my college wouldn't accommodate her, but talking to the business department, what he was saying is even if you do some type of musical like theater or theatrics or something like that, you still, if running your own business, you still want to take some type of business to make sure that people are not going to be ripping you off, you know? So, like he told her, like, everybody pretty much takes the same classes, like, you know, course classes for the first 60 credits. And he was telling her, no matter what school or what thing that you go into pertaining to business, everyone is taking the same classes. And that's what I was trying to explain to her, because she was saying, no, they don't have my classes and they don't have the courses. Like, she's trying to put the car ahead of the horse. And basically what he was telling her is slow down, focus on, you know, your basic courses, and focus on whatever course that you have to do that has to gear towards business. So they also have a tour going on today at 11:30. She gets to tour the campus, tour the music department, tour the arts department, just to, you know, get an overall sense of exactly what it is that she wants to do and what they offer. They do have a radio station on campus. They do have like a theater place on campus. Like, it's just so much that CSI offers that I'm hoping that she loves this school as much as I do, y'all. I really truly love my college campus. Also, I checked out the nursing. I kind of already knew that the nursing course was very, very demanding. You have one shot and one shot only. The courses that I took together a couple of years ago, remember when I told you I unofficially withdrew? Those were the courses that I needed for my nursing. And the way it's so competitive, what they said was the nursing demand is like 10%. Like my borough pretty much commands 10% of the nursing field, of people going into the nursing field, and it's just so freaking competitive. That with my grades that I got when I was here before, I really honestly don't think I'm going to qualify for this nursing program here. I'm still going to come here to take my basic courses. I just don't want to waste my time, because now you need your BS. You need another degree that goes along with, I think it's your BN, that goes along with nursing, that you didn't need a couple of years ago. So to be a nurse can take you about 6 years in college. And I don't really want to be in college for 6 years. Hi, how are you?
Hi, how are you?
Good.
I'm
everything's good.
Studies.
Good.
Okay, bye.
I just really don't want to be on this road for 6 years and then a possibility of me not actually getting into the nursing program, which is okay. My main focus is really nursing, but also dealing with children with special needs, and I can go into that field on many different levels. I can go in as a social worker. I can get my nursing associate's degree and then do a minor in social work. I just really want to work with adults and children with special needs. And I can do that on any level, any career field. It's just, I don't know. But before I discourage myself from the nursing program, what I'm going to do is make an appointment to speak with the nursing advisor and have them guide me on what I need to do. In each class, you need a 3.0. I don't have a 3.0. So, and then with me starting out late, I don't know. It kind of worries me. Like I said, I know that I am a very determined person. So I know for a fact that anything I set my mind to, I will accomplish. It's just the chances of me getting into the nursing program on my college campus is slim. With the mistakes that I did when I was here before a couple of years ago, it kind of minimized my chances of really getting into the nursing program. So like I said, you have one shot and one shot only. They only, let's say if they have like 200 applicants, they only select a minimum of 75, not even that. So I don't know. I'm gonna see. I'm not gonna give up. I just think that I just need to tweak my goals. Like I said, I'm 41 years old. I don't want to be going into 50 and just getting out of college. I don't want to do that. So, you know, when you're younger, you make mistakes that you just don't understand how that may impact you years to go. And because of that, I just have to tweak what my goals were. I'm still going to college, y'all. And, like I said, I love this place. This place is like home away from home. I feel whole when I'm here. I feel accomplished. I feel amazing on my college campus. And, my lipstick is all cracking up because I had it on for a very long time. So, yeah, that's it. So, we have an 11:30 tour for my daughter. I'm really hoping that she picks CSI. I really do. But like I said, at the end of the day, the last decision is up to her. So, but I could be a mom and push her along the way, right? So, that is it. I will come in here later and run my mouth. Yeah. So, remember to say good morning, good evening, good night to someone with a smile. It'll definitely brighten their day, evening or night. And God bless you all. And I will talk to you later. And stay positive, y'all. Just stay positive. If I know I say this all the time, but I truly mean it. If you're trying to accomplish your goals, if you're trying to just, like I keep saying, an idle mind is the devil's playground. You have to keep your hands and mind, your mind and hands busy at all times. And just stay away from negativity. Be positive. Be encouraged. Accomplish your goals. Because this has been a 10-year goal for me, and praise God, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, I am able to accomplish that. So I'll talk to y'all later. Bye.